And local Tea Party members are celebrating after the Wisconsin governor's victory in that recall election. Many see it as a big win for the policies they stand for. As News 4's Sean Mozzarello explains, the Greenville Tea Party hopes to use that momentum going into the June 12th primary.
USA!
They don't hold rallies around here like they used to, but don't be fooled. Greenville Tea Party members say they are still very active.
There's a lot of activity going on under the radar.
Don Rogers says that work includes supporting candidates Tea Party members approve of in next week's primary. He says many Tea Party hopefuls were taken off the ballot, though. That happened when the state Supreme Court ruled candidates who did not file their paperwork correctly were ineligible to run.
What do you do whenever you're given such a defeat as that? You have to get up and move forward. And what is going to happen is we're going to be doing petitions.
Rogers says Tea Party members will help with those petitions. Many of them are challengers to Republican incumbents Tea Party members call rhinos. Republican in name only.
There's one easy way to find out a rhino is in your midst. You look at his voting record. The Greenville Tea Party has a scorecard.
Therein lies the mission of the Tea Party, a political organization which refuses to give up its influence on the political landscape locally and statewide. Sean Mozzarello, WIFF News 4, Greenville.
And by the way, the Greenville Tea Party holds its regular meeting tomorrow night at 6:30 at Zen in Greenville. Anyone interested in learning more about the Tea Party is invited.